Perfectionism is not the same thing as striving to be your very best. Perfectionism is the belief that if we live perfect, look perfect, and act perfect, we can minimise or avoid the pain of blame and judgement. Hands up if you've ever been in a situation where you've been handed an essay or a project or any type of project, whether that's writing, drawing, and you're given the task and you end up unnecessarily spending way too much time on planning it, overthinking how you're going to be writing it, and obsessing over the very small details like deleting paragraphs, rewriting, changing the words, where should I put the comma, are the colours right? The focus now is all about the end product. It has to be absolutely perfect. So then you get to a point where the pressure just becomes too much and then you just give up altogether. And if you think about it, that is procrastination at its very extreme. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Rhoda and I'm a doctor working in the UK, and today I want to talk about perfectionism. It's something I've been thinking about a lot recently and it plays a huge part in our lives. I thought, why not explore this in video format, and hopefully you will get something from this. You know what, I've actually come to realize that striving for perfectionism is actually delusional, because you're trying to achieve the unachievable. So you're always going to be disappointed. And for me, it's been a little bit of a journey actually to not let other people's opinions or judgments influence the way in which I approach my work. As I've got a little bit older, I've realized that there is actually a lot of courage in vulnerability. This video, for example, I'm putting it out there knowing that this is not going to be my best ever work, knowing that this video is a step in many steps I'm going to be taking to improve and hopefully reach a point where I can say this is an excellent video. That principle can literally be applied to every facet of life, whether that's your schoolwork, whether that's your job, whether that's relationships, whether that's you wanting to be good at public speaking, whether that's you playing tennis. We all are a work in progress, and the only way in which we can improve, change, progress is by making mistakes and doing things imperfectly. And for me, it's always been a little bit tricky actually to balance having very high standards for myself and wanting to put out the best quality of work out there, whether that's writing, exams, whatever, and balancing it with accepting that whatever work we put out there is going to have mistakes, there are going to be faults, there are going to be flaws. And sometimes when that balance is skewed, I end up in a place where my efforts actually start to work against me, and you start worrying over very small details that sometimes are irrelevant. And then you get to a point where you're not really enjoying the work as much as you wanted to, because you know that you're working to a ridiculously high standard. Sometimes you may even end up in a place where you're avoiding doing things that you're not confident in or competent in altogether, and that can be a bit of a problem. And then there's something else that can influence how we do things, and that is something I like to call comparisonitis. And it becomes really difficult to not compare yourself with people out there, people who look like they've got everything and doing the very best that they can possibly be. Everything out there on the internet is very carefully curated. We're only exposed to people's highlights, and a lot of the time the whole story hasn't been told. We're not seeing how people have got to where they are. We're not seeing the years and years of hard graft, mistakes that they had to make, failures that they had to go through. We're not seeing any of that. The only thing we're seeing is the end product. If you imagine Olympic gold medal winners, you've seen them on the podium and you're thinking to yourself, wow, how did they do this? But what we don't see is how many years it took them to get to that elite level, how many mistakes that they had to go through, how much time they had to sacrifice in terms of training. Or if you're seeing A-grade students, it's hours and hours of work that you've not seen that has led to that grade. For this video, for example, it's taking me hours to script what I'm going to be saying. It's going to take me another half an hour to an hour to actually film this. And then it's going to take me another few hours to actually edit everything, to get rid of the ums and the ahs and get rid of all the stutters and the silences. And you guys see the end product of it, which is just this video where I'm being able to talk very comfortably without stuttering, without saying the wrong thing. And you think to yourself, oh God, she's really good at public speaking, or she's really good at talking to a camera. But what you don't see is all the stuff that I've edited out. So do you see what I mean? And in essence, perfectionism comes from a place where you're never going to be good enough, because you're comparing yourself with other people whose whole story you didn't see. You're setting yourself very unrealistic standards in terms of what you're able to achieve, and not being able to accept that you can't make any mistakes. So you're always going to be dissatisfied. You're always going to be disappointed with whatever shortcomings that you have. Work as much as you wanted to, because you know that you're working to a ridiculously high standard. And then sometimes you may even end up in a place where you're avoiding doing things that you're not confident in or competent in altogether. And that can be a bit of a problem. And even if it's my first attempt at something, whether that's writing or this YouTube video, I have this tendency to think to myself, it needs to be absolutely perfect. And sometimes it can be a little bit difficult to manage my expectations and say to myself, Rhoda, this is your first ever video. Of course it's not going to be perfect. Of course it's not going to be absolutely flawless. There's no such thing as a perfect video. And to come to a place of acceptance where any work you put out there is bound to have mistakes. And the only way to improve, the only way to generate new solutions, new ideas, is to make mistakes. And my example is when I'm tutoring or mentoring, I welcome people making mistakes because it's a place where can we start working on? How can we improve this? It becomes a point where you can start building upon. And the thing with perfectionism behavior is you overcritical over your own shortcomings. And it may seem a little bit counterintuitive, but perfectionism is actually an obstruction rather than an aid. And this is perfectly demonstrated, no pun intended, by two psychologists, Yerkes and Dodson. And they created a curve, a pressure performance curve, that basically shows how problematic perfectionism can really be. And you can see on the left side of the curve, when there is very low pressure, so there's no motivating factors whatsoever, you've no deadlines, you know, things are just happening, you can see that the performance is going to be very low. And then you can see here in the middle is where there's just enough pressure to get the best possible performance. So you can see when we go towards the right, the higher the pressure becomes, the less our performance is. So the pressure here would be setting yourself very unrealistic standards, having very tight deadlines, doing all-nighters, cramming. So then we end up in this place which is called the zone of delusion. And that is where the pressure is so high, the performance actually declines really rapidly. And then you start falling into the territory of like burnout and just not doing very good. This is when things like anxiety and depression and burnout and stress really, really rear their ugly heads. And for that, we have to really talk about motivation. What is it that actually drives us? And there's actually two types of motivation. There is extrinsic motivation and then there's intrinsic motivation. Intrinsic motivation is where you're driven by your own internal rewards. You're basically doing it because you're enjoying it. You're doing it because of the pleasure of the process. Truly creative work or other endeavors and pursuits like relationships, you know, schoolwork, exercising, hobbies, really flourish when they come from a place of peace and acceptance. External motivation is where you're doing things other than the reason for your own personal enjoyment. So I don't want people to think I'm bad. I don't want people to think I'm stupid. Such and such is 10 times better than me. So now you've gone in with that kind of pressure of doing something for the sake of other people. And unsurprisingly, you're not gonna enjoy the process of it. If anything, you're gonna be put off by doing it in the first place because you think to yourself, what's the point? Such and such is much better than me, or whatever I'm gonna be putting out there is not gonna be very good anyway. And that can be a very toxic place to be. And the ways in which we can really work on letting go of these perfectionist tendencies is through having a positive mindset. One of the things that's a problem in perfectionism is being very critical of yourself, not giving yourself space to breathe or space to be messy or experiment. And having that positive mindset in terms of being kind to yourself when you've made a mistake or you didn't get that grade that you wanted or you didn't perform very well when it comes to your essay or whatever, is thinking to yourself, right, I've done my very best that I can possibly do. I know what I need to do to improve. So I'm gonna go into it next time knowing what I need to correct and how to go about doing it again. And in that way, you've taken off so much pressure from yourselves. Imagine a best friend talking to you as you talk to yourself. You know, you've not done very well, for example, in your exam, or I didn't put out the very best work that I can possibly do. And your best friend says, that was horrible, that was not very good, how dare you, you don't know anything, this and that. You would let that friend go in an instant. But why do we allow ourselves to be subjected to that from our own heads, basically? The other thing is setting yourself realistic standards, things that you can easily achieve. There's nothing wrong with wanting to reach excellence, but we have to try and be flexible with ourselves that, no, we're human at the end of the day. There's a lot of things that can influence how we approach things. Comparing yourself with yourself, So yesterday's self to today's self, and I promise you, whatever thing that you're doing, you'll notice some kind of an improvement. And in that way, you're seeing the progress that you're putting in, but also you're using your own standards as a reference rather than anything else out there, whether that's your friends, whether that's other people. The last thing is, we're all a work in progress. You know, we humans fundamentally are not perfect beings. So there's no such thing as the perfect product or the perfect piece of work. And that is something I've slowly been coming to terms with. Anyway, guys, I hope you've took something away from that. I just wanted to try something different here. Let me know in the comments what you thought of this video, or whether I should do some more videos around kind of, you know, general life, personal development, that type of thing, alongside my study stuff. If you've got this far in your video, kudos to you. Comment, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.